So today we'll start with the revision of projectile motion. First we'll go with the theory and then we'll solve some questions. So projectile motion is a two-dimensional motion, that is motion in a plane. So here I have considered xy plane for the motion. I have considered first the simple projectile motion. What do I mean by simple projectile motion? The body is projected from the ground and it lands on the ground. The body is projected with the initial velocity u with angle of projection theta. So I can resolve this velocity into two components, x component and y component. So this is the x component and this is y component of initial velocity. From the diagram it is clear that the value of x component, that is ux, is equal to u cos theta and uy is equal to u sin theta. There is no acceleration acting along the x axis, so acceleration along x axis will be equal to 0. And the acceleration acting along y-axis is g. Since g is acting downwards and body is moving upwards, acceleration will be taken as minus g. Now we have resolved our two-dimensional motion into individual one-dimensional motions. And on one-dimensional motion, we can apply the kinematic equation. The kinematic equation known to us are v is equal to u plus at, then this one. And last is s is equal to ut plus half ut square. So these equations can be applied to individual x component and y component. So according to this, the value of final velocity, that is v, vx is equal to ux plus axt. Similarly, vy is equal to uy plus ayt. As acceleration along x axis is 0, vx will be equal to ux, that is equal to u cos theta. And Vy will be equal to value of Uy is u sin theta, Ay is minus g t. Okay, so this is the equation for Vx and Vy. Now, also we can apply the equation for displacement Sx. So Sx is uxt plus half axt square and Sy is uyt plus half ayt square. So we'll move to this further. So for projectile motion, we need to derive equations for the four components. That four factors are written on the right-hand side corner. That is time of flight, horizontal range, maximum height, and the trajectory. So first we'll start with the time of flight. First of all, what do we mean by the time of flight? The time for which the projectile is in air. It means what? The time required by the body to travel from initial position to the final position is known as time of flight. Now since the time required from start to end is t, so horizontal range means what? The maximum, the distance travelled by the body along x-axis is known as horizontal range. Maximum height means what? The maximum distance covered by the body along y-axis is known as maximum height. And trajectory is what? It is the path followed by our body, which is parabola. But we will also see the equation of the trajectory. Now, since the time required from start position to end position is capital T, the time required from start position to reach up to the maximum height will be its half, that is T by 2. So, first we need to calculate the equation for time of flight. So, what we can do is, you need to know that when the body is at maximum height, there is only one component of velocity acting, that is velocity along x-axis. Velocity along y-axis over here is 0. Why velocity along y-axis is 0? Because the body will not further move upwards. That's why velocity along y-axis here becomes 0. So we are going to make use of this condition to solve the equation for, to get the equation for time of flight. Now, Vy is equal to 0 when distance is h and time required for it is how much? T by 2. So we will substitute these conditions in our equation. So I will label here the equations. This is equation number 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay. So what I will do, I will substitute these values in equation number 2. So substituting the values in equation number 2. Substitute the values. So Vy will become 0. Then u sin theta minus g and time required is how much? That is t by 2. If I solve this, I will get the value of t is equal to 2u sin theta by g. This is the derivation for time of flight. Now from this line of light, we can calculate the value of horizontal range as well as maximum height. So first we'll start with the horizontal range. So horizontal range is this distance along the x-axis. Now when body has traveled for time capital T, that is from start to end, the distance covered will be equal to what? R. So we can substitute these values, that when distance is R, time is equal to capital T. So Sx will be equal to range when time is equal to time of flight. So we will substitute these conditions in equation number 3. Okay, so I will substitute in equation number 3. So my value will become, this is equation number 3. So instead of Sx, I will write down range. That is equal to Ux is how much? U cos theta. Time is capital T. And as Ax is 0, this component will vanish. So U cos theta, time of flight, that is 2u sin theta by g. So your formula becomes 2u square. Formula becomes u square 2 sin theta cos theta by g. Okay. Now that will give the value of range is equal to u square 2 sin theta cos theta is nothing but sin 2 theta by g. This is the equation for horizontal range of the projectile motion. And next one is maximum height. So when the time is equal to t by 2, the distance travelled along y-axis becomes what? Height. So we will use this equation. What is the condition? Condition is displacement along y-axis is equal to h when time is equal to t by 2. So we will substitute this equation, substitute this condition in equation number 4. So we will substitute in equation number 4. This is your equation number 4. So we'll put up the values. So Sy will be h, Uy is u sin theta, time is t by 2 plus half, Ay is nothing but minus g, and t square means capital T by 2 the whole square. Okay, so we'll put the values. Therefore h is equal to u sin theta, substitute the value of t, t is how much? 2u sin theta by g, so t by 2 will be how much? U sin theta by g minus g by 2 into t by 2 the whole square. T by 2 is nothing but u sin theta by g. So squaring it, I will get u square sin square theta by g. So on solving this, we will get the value of h is equal to u square sin square theta by 2g. So here we got the equations for h, r and t. Now last one is trajectory, we will see it later. So first we will start with the problem solving by using these three equations. Now first question is, velocity of projection of a projectile is given by the equation u is equal to 5i plus 10g. We need to calculate the value for time of flight, range and the maximum. Now it is given in the vector form. So from I cap and j cap. I cap means velocity along x axis and j cap represents velocity along y axis. So from the given equation, ux will be equal to 5 and uy will be equal to 10. Okay. So we know the equation of time of flight in terms of 2u sin theta by g. Now t is equal to 2u sin theta by g. This is our formula. Now but here we don't know the angle of projection. Instead we know the value of ux and uy. Now as we have known ux is what, uy is what, u sin theta. So instead of writing u sin theta, I can write down 2uy upon g. Now substitute the values. 2uy is equal to 10 and we will take the value of g as 10 meter per second square. Okay. So the answer will be how much? 2 seconds. Okay. Next is we need to calculate the value of horizontal range. The formula for range is u square sin 2 theta by g. Now this can be again resolved as 2 u square 2 u sin theta into u cos theta. Correct? Because on solving this we'll again get this equation. So I have opened it up as 2 u sin theta into u cos theta upon g. Now u sin theta is nothing but uy and u cos theta is nothing but ux. That is nothing but 2 uy into ux by g. So I will substitute the values. So uy is 10 ux is 5 upon g is 10. So answer will be how much? 10 in terms of meters. Next is maximum height. Formula for maximum height is u square sin square theta by g. U square sin square theta is nothing but u by the whole square, u y square upon g. U y is again 10, 10 square upon 10. So answer will be equal to 10. Now next question is, what is the change in velocity when the body reaches maximum height with the projectile motion? Now change in velocity is nothing but, change in velocity is what? Final velocity minus initial velocity. Okay. Now what is the final velocity and initial velocity? Initial velocity u, initial velocity is u, which is written in terms of ux and uy. Okay, so initial velocity is nothing but u cos theta plus u sin theta in vector form. Now what is the final velocity? Now final velocity has been asked at the maximum height. We know at maximum height the velocity along y component vanishes. The velocity left is only along the x axis. That is nothing but, so final velocity v can be written as vx I cap plus vy j cap, but at maximum height, at maximum height, Vy is 0. Therefore, final velocity is only along x-axis. Now, Vx, the formula for Vx, we have seen earlier in the derivation. So, Vx is nothing but Ux, correct? Ux plus Ax t. Ax is 0, so this component vanishes. So, Vx is nothing but Ux. So, value of Vx is u cos theta. That is u cos theta. So, this is the value for initial velocity, this is the value for final velocity. So, change in velocity, therefore, change in velocity will be equal to final velocity, that is u cos theta minus u cos theta I cap plus u sin theta j cap. So, change will be equal to minus u sin theta along. Now the next question on projectile is, so now projectile is fired with initial velocity u at an angle of rotation of theta, and for that range is given to be r. Now if the initial velocity gets doubled with the same angle of projection theta, what will be the range? Okay, so the formula for range is what? So range is u square sine 2 theta by g. So range depends on, that is initial velocity u, angle of projection theta and acceleration g. In this case, acceleration g is not changing as well as angle of projection is not changing. The only factor which is changing is initial velocity u. So I see the dependence of r with respect to u. So I can write down r is proportional to u square because theta and g are constant. They are not changing. Okay. So according to initial condition, for initial case, the range is given to be r and velocity is given to be u. So, range is proportional to u square. According to second condition, I need to calculate what is the value of range. I'll put it as r dash. It will be proportional to. Now, here it is said that velocity is double. It means what? The second velocity u dash is 2 times u. So, I'll write down here u dash square, but u dash is nothing but 2u square, so it means what? New range is proportional to 4u square. So if I take the ratio of 1 and 2, so 2 divided by 1 will give me r dash by r is equal to 4u square by u square. Therefore, r dash is equal to 4. So your correct answer is option number. So now next question is, a ball is projected with initial kinetic energy E and angle of projection is 45 degree. So at the highest point, means at maximum height, what will be its kinetic energy? So initial kinetic energy is given to be E, correct? At this case, in this case, velocity is what? Velocity is V. V, velocity is U. U means what? U cos theta I cap plus U sin theta j cap. Okay. In second case, final kinetic energy at maximum height. We know at maximum height, it is given, y component of the velocity becomes 0 and the only component which is present is x component, and value of x component is how much? U cos theta. So at maximum height, velocity which is present is only Vy and its value is how much? U cos theta. So kinetic energy at this point will be equal to what? Half m, only component present is Vy. So half m Vy square. So answer will be half m U cos theta square. Theta is given to be 45 degree and cos 45 is 1 by root 2. So answer will be half m U square and 1 by root 2 the whole square is again 2. So answer will be 1 by 4 m u square. Okay. Now if I talk about initial kinetic energy is how much? According to our formula, initial kinetic energy will be half. Initial velocity is how much? U. So it will be half m u square. Okay. So therefore, final kinetic energy, I label it as kinetic energy dash. Therefore, kinetic energy dash upon initial kinetic energy will be equal to what? 1 by 4 m u square upon half mu square. Okay. So I'll get the answer as half. Therefore, kinetic energy, new kinetic energy at maximum height is equal to half of kinetic energy on the ground. It is half kinetic energy on the ground is how much? E. So answer will be what? Half E. In the next question, time of flight of projectile is given to be 10 seconds. Range is given to be 500 meters. And we need to calculate the maximum height. Okay, so we need to calculate maximum height. Formula for maximum height is u square sin square theta by g. The factors we should know is u, theta and g. Okay, given is what? Given is time of flight, that is 10 seconds, and range is given to be 500 meters. You will observe that we don't require the value of range to calculate this value. How come? For time of flight, formula is 2u sin theta by g. Here we require the component u sin theta. In time of flight, we can get the component u sin theta. So there is no use of range. So 2u sin theta is 10. So according to this, u sin theta will be 10g by 2. That is 5g. We take g as 10. So 5 into 10, that is equal to 50. So value of u sin theta becomes 50. Okay, so I will directly calculate the value of maximum height h. So h will be equal to, I can write it down as u sin theta the whole square upon g. U sin theta is 50 square minus 10, so it is 2500 upon 10, that is equal 2500 upon 10. So your value will be equal to, sorry, I'm not getting it to. So now value will be how much? 125 meters.
Now, as per the next question, a particle is projected at angular projection 30 degree with a speed of 20 meter per second. We need to calculate the speed of the particle after 1 second. So, initial velocity has been given, we need to calculate the final velocity. Now, as per the theory we have studied, Vx is Ux plus Axt and Vy is Uy plus Ayt. We are going to kinematic equation. Final velocity is along x component, final velocity along y component. Ux and Uy represent the initial velocity components. Okay. Now, your Ax is 0 and Ay is equal to minus g, that is written as 10. Okay. So, according to this, Vx will be equal to Ux and Vy will be equal to Uy minus 10 t. Now, Ux is nothing but u cos theta and Uy is u sin theta. U is given to be 20 meter per second and time given is 1 second. So, I'll substitute u 20 cos angular projection is 30 degree. So, your value will be 20 3 by 2, that is 10 root 3 is the ux component and uy component will be sin 30 minus 10 into 1, so that will be 0. Okay, so vy component and ux is 0. So vy component will be equal to 0 and ux is nothing but Vx, that is equal to 10 root 3. So we got both the components of final velocity, initial component and final component. Thus, the value of speed is given as 10 root 3. So this is the final speed after.
Next topic is trajectory of the projectile. So we will derive the equation for trajectory of projectile. The equation for displacement along x-axis and displacement along y-axis is already known to you. So we will substitute the values of ux, ax, uy and ay. So we will get the equation for displacement along x-axis and displacement along y-axis. Instead of writing sx, I will write down your x. Displacement along x-axis can be written as u cos theta t and displacement along y-axis can be written as u sin theta t minus g by 2 t square. From this part we will get t is equal to x upon u cos theta. So we will substitute this equation of t in the equation of y. So substituting value of t will get u sin theta x upon u cos theta minus g by 2, here it is t square, so x upon u cos theta t whole square. On solving this, you get tan theta x minus g by 2 u square cos square theta into x square. Taking this value as a constant a and taking this value as constant b, we'll get the equation of y as y is equal to ax minus bx square. If you properly see the equation, this equation represents an equation of a parabola. It means what? The trajectory of a projectile is a parabola where value of A is equal to tan theta and value of B is equal to g 2u square cos square theta. So we'll see the first question on trajectory. In this question, the initial velocity of projectile is given to be 20 meter per second. Angle of projection is given to be 45 degree. Equation for trajectory is represented as ax minus bx square, where a and b are constant. We need to find out what is the ratio of a is to b. From the equation, from the formula, value of a should be equal to tan theta and value of b should be equal to g upon 2u square cos square theta. So if I substitute the value of theta, it is tan 45 degree, value of a is 1. We will take g as 10. So 10 upon 2 into u square means 20 square. Cos square theta means cos 45 degree square. So if we solve this, we will get the value
as 1 by 40. So now we need to calculate the value of A is to B, that is 1 is to 1 upon 40, that is equal to 40 is to 1. So right answer is option number B.
So now next question. In this question, the equation for projectile is given to be in terms of x and in terms of y. And we need to calculate the value of angle of projectile. Okay. So x is given to be 3060 and 2y is given to be 9060 minus 9.8 t square. So I will convert in the form of y. So y will be equal to 96 by 2t minus half 9.8 t square. That is nothing but 48t minus half 9.8 t square. This is the equation of x and equation of y. According to our standard equations which we use during the formulation of trajectory, it is x is equal to u cos theta t and y is equal to u sin theta t minus g by 2 t square. Okay. So if I compare these equations, I will get the value of u cos theta as 36 and value of u sin theta as 48. We need to calculate the value of projectile, so I need to eliminate the term of u. So what I'll do, I'll take the ratio, this is equation 1, this is equation 2. So I take the ratio of 2 by 1. So I'll get u sin theta upon u cos theta will be equal to 48 by 36. That will be equal to 4 by 3. Therefore, u gets cancelled, sin by cos is tan theta. So tan theta is 4 by 3. Okay. So you got the answer of tan of angle of projection is equal to 4 by 3. So for this question, you should know about a special triangle. That triangle is 90, 53 degree angle and 37 degree angle triangle. So this is the triangle. In this triangle, if the angles are 90, 53 and 37, corresponding sides are 5, 4 and 3. So according to this triangle, value of tan 53, if you see, it will be how much? It will be 4 by 3. So we got the answer as 4 by 3 and tan 53 is 4 by 3. It means what? Value of theta is 53 degree. So we got the value of theta is 53 degree. But the options given are in terms of sine inverse. So I need to convert this value in terms of sine. So we know the value of theta is 53. Now from the triangle you can see that sine 53 degree is equal to what? Sine 53 will be what? Opposite side upon hypotenuse. This sine 53 is what? 4 by 5. It means what? 53 degree is sine inverse 4 by 5. 53 degree is nothing but our angle of projection. Okay. So I can say that theta is sine inverse 4 by 5. So our correct answer is option number 5.